There's no ease in Jahannam. A'udhu billah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for protection from that place because there's no ease. This life, we can only say, oh, you know, that thing was so hard, or that time in my life was like this or that. But there's still ease in this life, no matter how bad it gets. That's not the case for hellfire. That's not the case for Jahannam. Similarly, in Jannah, there is no hardship in Jannah. No matter how good it gets here, there's always something that's hard. There's something that's imperfect. That's not the case in Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes Jannah, لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. There is no khawf in Jannah, there's no fear in Jannah, and no sadness, no sorrow. If you think about the two emotions in this life which torture people most, what is it? It's fear and it's sadness. It's depression and it's anxiety. Some form of it. Those are the two that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again and again in the Quran explains that there's none of that in Jannah. Those two specifically. Khawf and sadness. Hazan. Okay, those are the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that we don't have in Jannah. Okay, third aspect of dunya. To understand dunya in order to master it is that this life is a test. You cannot succeed if you don't know it's a test. I might give you, you know, your professor might give you a piece of paper, and if you think that you're just supposed to doodle on there, that's one thing, right? But if he tells you, dude, this is your test, in fact, this is your final exam, you're going to perform a little differently, right? Than if it's just a scrap piece of paper, okay? If people go through this life and think it's just a scrap piece of paper, they don't do very well. They think that everything has no purpose, nobody's watching them, you just do whatever you want, you just doodle on that paper. So then they don't perform very well. But if you know that this life is a test, you were handed that final exam and your professor is going to grade it, you're going to do a lot differently. You're going to act a lot differently. You're going to do a lot better. So if Allah has told us, in Surah Al-Mulk for example, تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. He says that he is the one who created death and life in order to test you, which of you are best in deeds. So if you thought there was any other reason why he created life and death, there isn't. This is the reason. This is the reason. This is the reason, you guys, that we are on this earth. The reason why he created life and death is to test us which of us are best in deeds. So if we know that, we're going to respond much, much differently. We know we're being watched. You know you're being judged. You're in a competition, really. And all of us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّاتٍ عَرْضُهَا كَعَرْضِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, race to forgiveness from Allah, from your Lord, and Jannah, whose expanse is like the heavens and the earth. Allah is telling us to compete, to race. So we are in a competition. And there is a judge, and that judge is always watching. Allah is always watching. So he's going to judge, he is judging how we respond, how we act to everything coming our way. Everything is a test. Everything that happens to you is a test. Everything that doesn't happen is a test. The whole thing is a test.